Now, this week, I read about this man. You say, who is he? Well, he is an Australian, and his name is Andrew Chan. Andrew Chan is now notorious, infamous now, for being one of the leaders in a drug smuggling ring, now known as the Bali Nine. Andrew Chan, before he died in 2013, he wrote a letter called Dear Me, a letter that is intended to warn young people about the dangers of drugs. And later on, he wrote these words, "My life is a perfect example of an absolute waste that does not have to be for you." Andrew Chan would be the first to admit that he lived foolishly. He was killed, executed this week, Wednesday morning, midnight, with a shot to his heart. But when he died, he demanded, or he insisted, he will not be blindfolded. What was he doing before he died? He was singing. Singing what? Singing Amazing Grace. You see, while he was in prison, Christians went and preached the gospel. He came to know Jesus, and he said, "When I got back to my cell, I said, 'God, I asked you to set me free, not kill me.' But God spoke to him and said, 'Andrew, I have set you free.' Free from what? Free from sin, free from folly. From the inside out, I have given you life." What kind of a life? Not physical life, but spiritual life. And from that moment, he says, "I haven't stopped worshipping him." So why is this wicked man who dealt with drugs so confident and so excited to meet their God? Did he do some great things in prison to turn that around? No. But Jesus did something great 2,000 years ago. And he believed Jesus. He trusted in the finished work of our Savior. And his life can be changed. My friends, if you're walking the path of the wicked, the love and the mercy of God is here to lead you back. Won't you turn from your sin and trust in Jesus Christ, his Son? May you truly be wise today.